Hey fellow beauty finders, it's Matthias for Makeup, and today on my channel, I hope you guys are excited. I'm going to be letting you get ready with me.
Get out, G-R-W-M.
I'm so glad you guys are back on my channel. I was super excited about this entire look and these lips. In my newest Get Ready With Me, I'm going to show you an entire new collection of products. Tons of new products that I've been getting for winter and the upcoming spring seasons. I am so excited to be sharing them with you in this step-by-step Get Ready With Me tutorial. It's like Wendy Williams on acid.
How are you doing?
You guys like Wendy Williams? I'm obsessed. I met her once when I was in New York. She was a huge fan of Joel McHale, my client on The Soup on E! Television for 10 years. And I was so excited to meet her. I've also met her makeup artist, Morel. And Morel is super talented. And someday when he's in LA, I'm going to grab him and I'm going to interview him for my weekly Monday Makeup Chat series. Because he is an awesome makeup artist. You know, red carpet season just ended. I got to use a ton of new products on so many of my clients here in Hollywood, California, and I wanted to try them on myself. So in today's Get Ready With Me, it is going to be a first impressions bonanza because I've never used any of these products on myself. So I would love for you guys to sit with me, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, because I do 2 or 3 videos every single week, and I hope you guys enjoy what you're about to see. So let me know in the comments below, click thumbs up if you enjoy the video, and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so the first thing that I want to show you guys is the brand new IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Primer. This is an oil-free, skin-perfecting serum primer, so it felt very hydrating on my skin. It also has fantastic ingredients like Moroccan lava clay and purifying charcoal. Starting next week, I'm going to break down this entire makeup series and show you guys step-by-step what my first impressions are of each of these products. So make sure you subscribe for that upcoming series. Okay, you guys, so the next thing that I'm going to give you my first impressions of is the new Sigma Cosmetics 3D HD Blender. As you can see, this is completely different than the traditional beauty blender that a lot of makeup artists and YouTubers are using. The way that it is cut is really kind of cool. I can't wait to try this. And I'm also going to be giving you a first impressions of the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. Now, I've used this on many, many models and clients over the last few months. You can see that on Snapchat and Instagram, and if you follow my blog. I'm going to try this on myself for the first time, and I hope I love it on me as much as I do on everyone else. All right, so I've wet my 3D HD blender from Sigma, and I've taken my All Nighter Urban Decay Foundation on a palette, and I'm gonna take a little bit of this foundation just on the side of the sponge, and I'm gonna dot it across my face. Okay, seriously, this is like so much coverage. Yeah, so make sure you get the ears, because, you know, that is a dead giveaway. Oh, honey, this sponge is perfect for getting in the ears. Damn! It's got like a built-in ear applicator. Oh my gosh, flawless. I love this foundation so much. Okay, so next I'm going to show you the Anastasia Beverly Hills Concealer in 3.0. This is very creamy, it is very full coverage, and it's very hydrating, especially for around the eyes. And I'm going to be applying that with the Sigma Precision Tapered P86 brush. Okay, so to blend out my highlighting concealer, I'm gonna take the sponge and I'm gonna take the clean side that I don't have the foundation on, and I'm gonna see exactly how this works. Now, I really love the point, and the Beauty Blender has a point on the sponge as well, but I think I really love this flat side of this a lot. I'm really loving how that fits right there and goes right in. And the density of the sponge feels very, very, very similar. I mean, they obviously were inspired by the Beauty Blender, and they did an excellent job of getting the same kind of feel and the same kind of texture in the sponge. I mean, I would say that this is like a must-have. Now, if you've watched a lot of my YouTube videos, you know that at this point, I, as a professional makeup artist, really like to put the setting spray on. I like the setting spray to actually go into the kind of warm foundation and concealers before I even powder. But because I'm not going to be wearing this makeup for the next 12 hours, I'm just going to go right into the RCMA Translucent Loose Powder. Now, if you don't have a traditional powder puff to apply this powder for your oily skin, I recommend the Sigma Bake Kabuki F89 brush. Now, see the way that this is shaped? This is shaped so that you can dip right into loose powder and you can really, really heavily put it right underneath the eye and bake your face with it, or just push it into the skin like this and make sure that all of your foundation is just really kind of mattified with the loose powder. I'm gonna actually take this brush and brush away any of the excess powder from applying it with the powder puff before I move on. Now I'm using the Urban Decay Brow Tamer in the shade Warm Brown to give my brows a little bit more emphasis, drama, definition, but without looking like heavily drawn on. Okay, so now that my complexion is done and I've added a little bit of tinted brow gel to my eyebrows, I'm gonna show you the brand new BH Cosmetics Carly Bybel 10 color and 4 color highlighter palette. So this is brand new. It has some really gorgeous shades. I'm excited to get my hands on them. I'm excited to play with them and see how they work. Now I'm gonna take that Bake Kabuki F89 brush from Sigma and I'm gonna add a lot more powder under my eyes in case there is any fallout. I don't wanna mess up my skin. And then I'm gonna take my Soft Focus Shader E52 brush from Sigma and I'm gonna go into the neutral bone color here in my Carly Bybel palette. Then I'm gonna take this color right here, which is more of a neutral, warm, nutmeggy color, and my Tapered Blending E40 brush from Sigma. Now following through with that same kind of pinky mauve undertone, I'm gonna take my Sigma Airbrush Blender F63 brush, and I'm gonna dip into the deepest, darkest kind of plum color right over here on the outside. Now there is one more deep dark color right out here that kind of looks like a grayish brown. I'm gonna try that just to deepen that kind of concave just a little tiny bit more. And I'm gonna use the Pencil E30 brush from Sigma. Now I've kept my eyelids right above the pupil of my eyes very clean and light. So I'm gonna go in with the Eye Shading E55 brush from Sigma and I'm gonna pick one of these sparkly shades on the second row. So I'm gonna start with this one right here and see how much pigment there is in this shimmer shadow.
Hello, there's a lot of pigment.
Now I'm gonna be doing some eyelining on my eyes and I'm gonna be showing you three brand new pencils from Makeup Forever. I'm gonna be showing you the Aqua XL eye pencils, completely waterproof, and I'm showing you S20, which is a navy blue, M16, which is a white, and M10, which is a basic black. All right, so I love a white pencil on the inner waterline under the eye, and I wanna see exactly how well this goes on, because finding a white eyeliner pencil, which is really strong and vibrant, is like finding a needle in a haystack, to tell you the truth. Now, lastly, to add a little bit of fun kind of pop under the eye before I add mascara, I'm gonna show you this really cool navy blue, S20. Okay, so for a very extended kind of hyperreal cat eye, I'm gonna use MAC Black Track Black Gel Liner and the Eyeliner E11 brush from Sigma. Okay, so next I'm gonna show you the Paris Manning Velvet 59 mascara called My Fair Lashes. This is a mascara that I've never used on myself before. I actually really love the applicator because it has one of those little balls at the end, which almost looks like kind of like a Game of Thrones kind of like killing device, you know, with the spikes on the end. They But this works really good, I think, when I use it on other clients. So let's see how it works on me for the first time. I love how dark the pigment was and how easy it was to just kind of get on two coats. Next, I'm going to apply some Violet Voss Faux Mink Lashes that I can't wait to try on myself. Okay, this glue is way too strong.
Ugh. It's almost like a silly putty glue. Oh my god.
Oh my god, that lash is so sexy. Now I'm going to fill in my brows and make them a little bit extra glamorous and a little bit more defined, and I'm going to show you with the BH Studio Pro Ultimate Brow Palette. So this is from BH Cosmetics, and inside the palette you will see 12 different pans. You actually get 4 waxes down at the bottom in different colors, ranging from light to dark and clear, and then you get 2, 4, 6, 8. I had to do a little counting, a little mathematician action right there. You get 8 colors to choose from as well. So I'm gonna start by using my Sigma brush. This is the Line Perfector E68 brush. So as you guys know, if you've watched my YouTube channel for months or years, I love to educate. So in order to really truly go into depth on how to use these products and how to make them work for you, I've had to break down this entire makeup demo into a multi-part series. So I will be going over the steps and the techniques on how to use this brow product, as well as all the other products in this demo. So please make sure you're subscribed and let me know your comments and thoughts down below. Now I'm going to define my nose and my cheekbones a little bit by contouring and highlighting, and I'm going to be using the Infinite Contour Palette from Cosette. Now I'm going to be using the Soft Blend Concealer F64 brush from Sigma. Now, I don't want my nose to be as snatched as my cheekbones, so I'm definitely going to go in with the lighter of the two shades that I showed you. And I'm going to be using the Small Tapered Blending E45 brush from Sigma. Next, I'm going to be showing you another Cosette palette that just came out this year. I'm so excited to be trying this for the first time on myself. This is the Infinite Blush palette, so you get a ton of colors to choose from. And I think I'm going to go with something really neutral but kind of poppy, so I think this one right here. So I'm using my Sigma Small Contour F05 brush, and I'm going to go right into this and pop this right on top of my cheekbone, right above where the contour line was placed. And honey, wow, that is a beautiful pigment. Next, I'm going to show you a brand new product from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It is the Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit collaboration product. So this product just came out. I am so excited to be trying this on myself, and I think for me, I'm going to try a little bit of Daydream on top of this blush contour combo just to add a little bit more shine to the top of my cheekbones. Okay, so I really want to see what the white one looks like. I know I'm super tan. I want to take a tiny, tiny bit of Forever Lit, and I'm going to add that to the inner corner on the bottom of both eyes, right above where I put that white pencil, and then just a touch right up here in the center with what's left on the brush. Maybe just a tip on the nose, just a tiny bit, you know, it just helps sometimes. Okay, next I'm going to show you the new High Precision Lip Pencils from Makeup Forever. These also just came out. I have two shades here. I have a lighter and a deeper kind of neutral beigey brown, maybe with a little bit more of a pinky undertone. So I think I'm gonna go with the lighter of the two. See how I just changed my mind? Did you guys see that? I was like, no, not that. Okay, so I'm gonna show you. This one is number 13. Now I'm gonna go in with this deeper one, which is number 14, and I'm gonna just overline my top lip just a touch. To finish off the look, I'm going to pull out one of my brand new Vice lipsticks from Urban Decay. Now, I've never tried these on myself, so I'm very excited to see what they feel like. I'm going to show you Trick, which is one of their metalized lipsticks. So Trick, as you can see, is very, very light. It's almost a nude kind of champagne beige. So it says metalized on it, so I would imagine it's going to have a lot of like flecks of glitter or sheen on them. So let's see how it looks. Wow, I love the combination. If you guys could see that like super up close, there is like so much shine in there. It almost looks on camera like I'm wearing lip gloss, but I'm not. So these are very, very, very moisturizing. I think it pulls the whole look together and I'm totally happy. I hope you enjoyed this full glam transformation step by step. If you did, please do leave me a comment down below and click thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Now, make sure you subscribe to my channel because very, very, very soon I'm going to be giving you a detailed first impression of each of the products that I used in today's demo. So please do subscribe and make sure your notifications are set to on. Now, before you guys go, check out one of these other two videos right here because I've gotten ready with myself many times before and I have tons of new products and tons of products that I'm dying to share with you. So click on one of these other two videos and I will see you guys very, very soon. Thanks, you guys. Bye for now. I don't want to take my face off. It's so pretty. Like, literally, you guys, I swear to God, it took me like 4 hours to shoot this entire frickin' series, but I'm all about it right now. I am so happy. I need to Snapchat. Where's my phone?